This video is for informational purposes only. There are risks to jailbreaking your iDevice, and it does void your Apple warranty. So think before you act.
Hey guys, Matt here from todaysiphone.com. Today we're going to be checking out full screen for the iPad. Now I know I normally do my videos on the iPhone, but unfortunately I lost my jailbreak and I spent 4 hours yesterday trying to get it back and was unsuccessful in my attempts. So I will continue to work on that. But today we're looking at full screen for iPad, which is an application that is offered on both the iPhone and the iPad. So I figured I would show it to you guys on my iPad. The package costs $2.19 in Cydia. It is $2.19. Well spent. I really enjoy this. It's one of my favorite tweaks. So let's get actually right into it here. So what it does is it offers a full screen option in Safari. So let's take a look. We'll head over to Safari. And here it is in full screen looking at Engadget's website. If you do want to ever, you know, go back to having the nav bar up there, you just tap two times and you have your nav bar back. You tap twice, it disappears. Tap twice and hold, you get your menu. You can go back, go forward, scroll up, scroll down, you know, tab forward, tab back, create a new tab, close a tab, go into full screen mode, open up a bookmark, refresh the page, or go to a specific URL which you identify in the options. So press full screen again and it'll bring back the nav bar. Overall, guys, it just makes looking at a website so much more comfortable, so much more, you know, all your focus is on the website, eyes are on the prize. I really, really enjoy this, guys. Let's just go to another website so you can see. Something as simple as Google. You know, get rid of the ugly nav bar, and now it's just Google. You just focus on, you know, whatever you're searching, whatever you're doing. That's why I really like it, is because it takes away you know, the distraction of the actual nav bar, even though this is a very minimalistic design from Apple, and I really do like their nav bar, but I like it even better when it's not in the way. So let's go over to the settings and check out what full screen for iPad has to offer, and it has a lot to offer, really. It has a whole bunch of custom gestures you can add using two fingers, three fingers, one finger, short hold, one finger double tap and short hold. There's so many options. You guys can customize them, make them what you want. That's what I really like about it, is because I think so many other tablets, you know, use gestures like the BlackBerry Playbook and the touchpad. Now, I know they're not as successful as the iPad, but I would like to see more gestures in the iPad. So allowing to use gestures in Safari, thanks to full screen for iPad, it's a big plus. Here you can see what your pop-up will look like. You can have it in black and blue. There's a theme option right down here, pop-up theme, black, blue. So then we go back there. That's what it'll look like. I personally prefer the black, so we'll set that back. And then your other options are, you can start in full screen mode, keep it in the status bar, transparent button bar, or vibrate if gesture fails. Obviously it's not going to vibrate on the iPad, but it will wiggle if your gesture fails. And then, like I said, pop-up theme. And then there's that open URL. So if there's a URL you always use, you can put it right down there. And then when you go into full screen, or well, Safari, you just short hold, or one tap short hold, and you can go right to that website by pressing go to URL. Might be more convenient, might be inconvenient. That's your guys' call. But like I said, guys, just looking at websites on the iPad looks so much better when it's in full screen. So $2.19, guys, in the Cydia App Store. It is definitely $2 well spent, so head on over there, download it. Then, guys, please head over to todaysiphone.com for all the latest tech news. Then head over to my YouTube page, which is Homemade Geek Squad. The link is down below. Please subscribe to my channel. And then head over to your Twitter accounts, and then please follow me on Twitter. It is at Homemade Geek. Thank you guys so much for your time today. You guys have a great day, and as always, peace.